Hello everybody, myself is Surjit Akre. I am the first Indian artist who has achieved a postgraduate degree in easel painting from the Academy of Fine Arts, Repin Institute of Painting, Sculpture and Architecture in St. Petersburg, Russia. I am also the founder president of Rarix Art Club, affiliated to Russian Center of Science and Culture, New Delhi. I have an experience of 40 years as a professional artist. Let us start our painting. First of all, I will draw the composition. I am using 2B pencil. To compose the layout, you have to draw very lightly. Don't put too much pressure on the pencil. For that, you have to fold the pencil from the back. First, make the outline of the whole composition. You have to divide the forms according to the proportion and perspective. When most people think of the harmony in painting, they think about its structure, its composition. There are principles such as the golden mean, which say using a ratio of 1.61080339887 within the structure of one's work or even in the exterior shape of the work will provide maximum harmony. The second area of harmony is color. There are many theories about color. Too many generalized. The most common are simple harmony, which are thought to be generated by analogous colors. Colors next to each other on a color wheel. Then there are triadic colors. Color three apart from each other on the wheel. Each of these is deemed to be harmonious. However, the human eye can see 2.8 million colors, not those on a simple color wheel. And our feelings for the color are affected by age, gender, mood, lighting, setting, and innumerable other factors. So there is no broader brush to swipe with than that of color theory. We do know that some colors have longer vibrations than others, and therefore people react more strongly to them. Red, yellow. And if white is mixed in to get pastels, then emotional response will be more muted. The vibration is shorter. They literally cannot move us as much, so this clarity affects feeling of harmony as well. The final element is subject matter. I would say that these are the various pieces of the harmony puzzle. Then you take marker or sketch pen and draw the contour. I will use marker to make the contour of the form. Contour drawing is an artistic technique used in the field of art, in which the artist sketches the contour of a subject by drawing lines that result in a drawing that is essentially an outline. The French word contour meaning outline. Urdu drawing is arguably the purest form of drawing. Nothing but pure line. Most of us begin contour drawing instinctively, simply by picking a point on the edge of the figure and copying it onto our paper, hand following eye. This can yield a beautiful drawing. This line is called arabesque by academy artists, but without proper training, it can be difficult to achieve good results. A common problem with pure contour drawing is that as the tempo of drawing changes and as we focus in on one small area at a time, the proportions of the figure become lost. Gradually, errors compound and the figure becomes distorted. We need to learn to preserve the proportions of the figure. The best way to do this is to learn to draw the structure of the figure first. Markers are simple to use, require little preparation time, and dry quickly. The quality of your line is very important, and it can make or break a pencil sketch. Even though you are working quickly, you should still think about composition or give some thought to placing the figure or object in an environment. masters for inspiration when you are drawing sketches. Look for Carnarny effect in your anatomy sketches. For instance, in the art Enro, joint might jump out into space. Perhaps you could emphasize it with a heavy overcutting. Look for bones. Look for the separation of muscle function. After finishing the drawing, now it is time to think your color combination. In painting as well as in interior decor, graphic design, photography, fashion design, garden design, and all artistic expressions, the choice of colors determines the mood of the creation, the level of energy that will be conveyed, and if it's a pleasant to revere or not. You can apply the colors direct, or you can first cover the whole canvas with one base color. When you paint on base prepared canvas, it is easy to work and have a harmony in colors. So firstly, I will make a base. I will use the greenish gray for base color. I will mix black and white, little bit dark green, which will give cool shade of gray. Fill the gray color in whole canvas. Keep the contour of the drawing visible. To provide visual unity to the painting, use one color base canvas. The main advantage of using prepared canvas is that the painting will look visually appealing and balanced. Color harmony is the theory of combining colors in a fashion that is harmonious to the eye. In other words, what colors work well together? Analogous color scheme use colors that are next to each other on the color wheel. They usually match well and create serene and comfortable design. Analogous color schemes are often found in nature and are harmonious and pleasing to the eye. make sure you have enough contrast when choosing an analogous color scheme. Analogous color scheme employs colors that are close to one another on the color wheel. Typically, you choose three colors, but you can use a minimum of two to a maximum of five adjacent colors. So I have applied yellow ochre in the right side of figure. You can use this shade as a middle tone. To make the dark shade, I just overlap this color again and again. For light, I apply pure white. I use this same tone as left also, which will balance the composition. In this composition, we will use cool warm color combination. Warm colors are red, orange, yellow ochre, and cool colors are blue, green, violet. Use a limited painting palette. Don't feel that you have to use all the colors in your painting at once. You can use any color you like depending on whether you want cool or warm painting. This will allow you to get the feel of the paint. When you are ready, add a warm and cool of each primary color to your palette along earth tone like burnt sienna, burnt umber and yellow ochre. Understanding warm and cool colors can intensively give your painting a sense of harmony. A limited palette is efficient. If you had three colors on your palette and use those colors consistently, you would get to know them very well. Complementary colors. I apply blue tone next to yellow and other side red. Complementary color scheme. A complementary color scheme employs colors that are directly opposite to each other on the wheel. The color pairs always consist of either a primary with the secondary color, red and green, yellow and violet, blue and orange, or two tertiary colors, red orange and blue green, yellow green and red violet, yellow orange and blue violet. I'm using dark green here near the yellow ochre, which gives contrast. There is no one right color for a painting. There is only a right color in relationship to the other color around it. Every color affects the color adjacent to it and is in turn affected by the adjacent color. As observed in and explained by the law of simultaneous contrast. That is why it is possible to create a representational painting with a limited palette that has beautiful color harmony, even though the color on the painting might not be the color you actually see in the real world. Split complementary scheme. The split complementary is a variation of the complementary color scheme. In fact, it uses a color and then the two colors on each side of its complement. For example, violet, yellow green, and yellow orange. This produces high contrast without the aggressiveness of the complementary scheme. It is very versatile and creates a pleasant atmosphere. At the background, I am using dark gray. It takes only a little of a dark color to change a light color, but it takes considerably more of a light color to change a dark one. So, for example, always add blue to white to darken it rather than trying to lighten the blue by adding white. That way you won't end up mixing more of a color than you want. The base color gives very soothing effect. To focus on the focal point, I give the contrast near the focal point. Triadic scheme. The triadic color scheme uses three color that are equally spaced around the color wheel. The scheme provides nice contrast and easier achievable color balance than the complementary scheme. It is recommended to use one color as the dominant color and the other two in lesser quantity. Example, blue, red and yellow. If the pure colors are overpowering, it is good idea to combine them with gray values or their complement to dull the intensity. There is light on the face and I put the black at the upper side of the background. There is transparency, so it gives the effect of gray. There are not color schemes that are better than others, but only those that are more suitable for the visual message you want to convey. As all the manuals on how to choose a wall color for a room suggest, you should first pick the mood you want for that room and then go from there. Do you want to create calm and tranquility, or do you prefer energy and vitality to be expressed? As shapes and lines transmit a sense of stillness, action, or energy, so do the colors you see. Based on the reaction you are trying to get from the viewer, you can select the colors to use with the help of the classic color scheme. Color harmony is achieved using colors that relate to one another in a specific way on the color wheel. In the background, I am using dark brown, which gives more dimension. The tetradic color scheme uses four colors that are two sets of complements. For example, yellow, violet, green, and red. The tetrad colors do not need to be equally spaced in the color wheel, as long as they are couple of complements. Because of the wide range of colors, this is the richest of all schemes, but also the most difficult to balance in a harmonious way. The best way to proceed is to make one color prevail and use the other case in a several ways. In this figure, I am using light gray, leaving the right side contour as it is because we have to put more light this side. Thank you. I am using here orange to give contrast. I put some shade on the face and arms. Put some details on the eyes. Thank you. Don't think about making art, just get it done. Let everyone else decide if it is good or bad, whether they love it or hate it. While they are deciding, make even more art. Andy Warhol. Dark blue color here gives contrast. Light green is very cool color. At last, you have to put some light on the focal point. For that, I am using pure white. Choosing the right color scheme from the start can be a huge help on each decision you have to take later. Ruling out options and narrowing possibility, but most of all, if you handle your chosen color well, you will be able to create a harmonious palette.